God save the Queen. Radio New Zealand National. This is the final broadcast of this network. Programming will cease from midnight tonight. As a consequence of the disestablishment of Radio New Zealand, this frequency will be reallocated by order of the Minister of Broadcasting. Archival material from Radio New Zealand and information on the winding up of the company may be obtained from the Ministry of Culture and Heritage. The time is 11:39. And now an extended bulletin of Radio New Zealand News. The constitutional dispute which has paralysed the capital for the last month and disrupted much of the nation's infrastructure and communications has come to an end today at Old Government House, Auckland, with the signing of a comprehensive agreement on the final status of New Zealand. The liberation movement, consisting of tribal authorities, supported by civil rights activists, unions and students, has said in a statement that today marks the beginning of the end for New Zealand and the end of the beginning for Aotearoa. The peace settlement will bring to a conclusion more than two centuries of British colonial presence in the South Pacific Islands and recognises the original authorities to whom the British will transfer sovereignty over the next 20 years. The agreement describes an orderly transition to independence in a constitutional framework of majority rule and local autonomy. The agreement guarantees the rights of Indigenous people to their land and culture, and guarantees the rights of the long-term settler population to residency and citizenship. The content of the agreement is virtually identical to the proposal rejected by the government when their delegation walked out of talks with the leaders of the liberation movement on Monday. Representatives of the New Zealand government, including the Attorney General and the Administrator of the government, and the British High Commissioner to New Zealand, put their signatures on the document at 3 p.m. following a ceremony at which several hundred iwi leaders signed on behalf of their respective tribes. Delegates from the Cook Islands, Niue and Tokelau have signified their government's acceptance as additional parties to the agreement. Today's events have capped off a dramatic week of escalating tension with mass arrests, prison riots and the spread of disturbances to previously unaffected districts. Electricity outages, telecommunication and travel disruptions and the sabotage of government websites had already affected everyday life and the national economy. News of the accord came suddenly. The first indication of a breakthrough came yesterday afternoon at a chaotic press conference at the Beehive. The government's show of unity collapsed during the course of questions when the Attorney General contradicted the Prime Minister on several points and the Mayor of Auckland, appearing on a video link, said the council had lost confidence in Cabinet's ability to end the deadlock and revealed that Auckland leaders had opened their own dialogue with the liberation movement. This morning, white flags were raised over government buildings in Auckland and on the harbour bridge. First official word of an agreement came after government representatives from Wellington arrived in the city by military helicopter just before noon. All hostilities in the country came to an end at 6 p.m. tonight under the terms of the settlement. So far there are no reports of any violations. Fire appliances were seen moving through blockades.